So in this playthrough, we are ultimately strictly obeying the real, you know, areas of where the USSR was. So I'm going to leave China in Korea. We don't need that. That's fine. We'll leave them alive. I don't need the diplomatic penalty. The world hates me enough already. I mean, ultimately, you know, this may be a problem soon, but we'll get to that when we get to it. But for a few turns, we're going to just consolidate. We're going to just hold in. Make sure we've settled everywhere we want, make sure my religion is spread across my empire, make sure my infrastructure is looking good. And then we should probably start to explore the world. What's Russia famous for? An air force? A navy? All of these things. We don't have any of them. Ugh, terrible. Yay for military aid request! Okay, that's actually Kublai. Now this is, no, that's not my raid request either. Peter! There we go. We were ravaged by a natural disaster. Everyone give Russia money. This isn't going to go through unless my allies decide to push this through, which is unlikely. There's the Incans, a good trading partner, I hope. They haven't actually done... Oh, it passed! It passed! Oh, everyone's in on it. Great. Great stuff. Okay, perfect. Look at that. Look at all these people that want to give me money. And I'm not at war with any of them anymore, he says, making quick peace with the Mayans. I'm not at war with any of them. Oh, Russia is at peace with the world for the first time in a long time. Saying that, I'm just about to go and ruin that with the fact that I'm just taking a load of luxuries and 264 gold per turn to go to war with Rome. Now, I think this may pull me into a war with Coupe, but that was fine. Oh, and Indonesia as well. Okay, that may have been a problem. I think I might actually have been getting money from them, so never mind. But that's okay. We're just meeting the world with all of these war declarations. This is fine. Yeah, look at this. The Incans really want to go to war with Scotland. Jealous of the mountains of Scotland, I believe. Well, that's fine. We'll do that as well. Oh, I think I might have just gone to Portugal. Okay, now that was a bit more of an issue, but my trade deal with them was expiring soon. So actually, that does work well. My money will just about reset from that. Yeah, I'm going to lose 400 gold per turn from going to war with Portugal there. But as soon as Portugal give me peace, I can go back and I can get a new trade deal with them because they're already on 500 gold per turn. So that actually may turn out to be a really good accidental play. Not that I deliberately did that at all. That was a total car crash move, but never mind. How do we feel about Russian Hokkaido? I think this is Hokkaido, isn't it? It's northern Japan. It's not really Coupe's land. I mean, ooh. I think you can make an argument both ways on this one. I think I quite like the idea of just getting a little closer to Alaska for no reason. No reason whatsoever. Let's just land a couple of Cossacks on this land and we'll forget about it. Don't worry, Coupe. Don't worry. It's radio. How much aluminium have I got? Okay, there's some in a field. That's not great. And there's... Oh, there's some under a campus. Okay, so I've at least got a little bit. That's better than none. Better than none. Okay, now that I've got radio, that means I can get broadcast centers, which are very good buildings, but I kind of want chemistry. That would be something that would be really, really cool. So economics, build two banks. I'm sure I can do that. Another war of Pedro, you say? Oh, the Kemens want to do it this time. Sure thing. Sure thing. You love it. Come on, I've got loads to sell. Come buy it, everyone. Come buy it. 26 gold per turn for some cold. There's 16 gold per turn, so we're up to 42. This will be 73. We've now got, oh god, 121? 123? Oh, I don't know. 150 gold. I've kind of given up on the exact maths of this one. That's a lot of upfront gold, which is really, really good. Oh, it's just so easy when you can do it like this. It's just like, who wants to buy? Come on. Perfect. Three Cossack attack. This is not the way to take a city. These guys are far too weak, but hey, it's working. It's working, and that's what matters. A little bit of spare pillaging as well whilst we're here. That'll do. Don't oh no. The USSR has mass media. Oh, what truthful and non-biased news we will all receive. It's just... Ugh. To be fair, we're kind of still in our, like, you know, the Tsar phase. We're in the monarchy phase. It's not going to last long. I can feel the sort of hints of a rebellion just sort of, you know, circling underneath. Who'd have thought Mulan would come to save the Russian Empire? Oh, she's brilliant. I love her. These guys are all slowly getting promoted, which is wonderful. I kind of need you to take this city now. Hooray! Oh, what a good way to meet the Kree. Nice to meet you. Now, if I can somehow ally myself with the Kree. I'll have a, you know, an ally right on the board with America, who will just be my super friend. Hang on. Open borders. Yay. So we've got open borders already. I'll give them... Ugh, there's no way. There's no way they're going to be my friends, is there? Oh, no. They did. They just made friends. Perfect. Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to go for a research alliance with them. Yes, and now, never look again. At this. Here comes the map. So the Crater Lake, Mato Tipila. Nice. I think we've just met... No, we didn't meet anybody else. I think we might have met everybody. And here's America. Oh, dear. America is not that big. Okay, so the Kree are my allies on this continent. But Canada, America, the Aztecs, Coupe's got a little bit here. Japan is here as well. What a messy continent. Come on, America. Sort it out. Oh, actually... Look at that. Oh, now I don't have a cultural alliance with the Kemens. The population at this side is not doing very good. So, I need to actually spend another one. Oh, actually, I can get Moksha in quickly. He can look after that city. There we go. Now it's loyal. Perfect. And actually, Armani, I need to put you back into somewhere fun. Indonesia. We want peace. Actually, I'm going to make peace with everybody I can. Let's keep doing it. Unless, actually, she's got tons of gold, in which case, peace sucks. She does have a lot of gold. And the Odyssey. Okay, what do you want to do, my friend? Who do you want to war with? Pachacuti? I feel like... Oh, Teddy. Okay. Right, hang on. Pachacuti, I feel like I've got a big deal with. Yeah. She wants to go to war with Teddy. Oh, my word. Russia. We can declare war on America. That is amazing. But it's the best sort of war. Because this is kind of like a proxy war, you know? Like, this has got nothing to do with my actual land. America are ages away from me. No, it's brilliant. A pillage, pillaging time. Venice doesn't need its stuff. I'm going to take its stuff. Doop-a-doop-a-dee-doo, doop-a-doo. Nobody minds. Ooh, whoa-hoo, that's exciting. China have sent a missionary to me. Yay! What fun, what fun. There's a couple of inquisitors are just going to appear mysteriously around this area. Oh my god, look at how many artifacts there are around. Holy moly. And I thought I was crazy going for artifacts, but nope. Nope, I need more archaeological museums. That was nuts. I thought it was right to build the Bolshoi Theatre in my capital. Just mainly because it was awesome, but also because Russia. Hashtag Russian things. That's a vampire castle, by the way. So I'm ruining the yields around it, but they don't lose the yields in the long run. So that's quite good. Oh, I think I just got Reformed Church as one of my three techs here. That's a bit of a waste. Never mind. Right, there's one field cannon. I just need to find another crossbow, which I'm sure I owe. Yeah, there we go. Here he is. And then Scorched Earth. So we're getting there. We're getting there. I'm just stealing Venice. I quite like the idea of like some little city-states on the side. Ooh, the Eureka for computers. I don't mind if I do. Lovelaces are very welcome. I think actually... I mean, I don't even have the mausoleum in this game. That's the stupid thing. But yeah, we're getting there. I'm just building a breathtaking neighborhood in my capital for conservation. I've just got the musketman upgrade for replaceable parts. Chemistry alliance level 2. We must have one of those soon. Like Menelik, I've had that alliance, well, pretty much the whole game. Where's our alliance? Oh, it's so close. Okay, I need to actually start trading with Menelik, probably. I don't even know the route to him, to be fair. He's down here somewhere. Who knows? Woohoo! I'm building breathtaking things, literally the turn that I flip into a new era. Isn't that wonderful? Hooray! Right, Hexong Draconis, Reform the Coinage, Heartbeat of Steam. Heartbeat of Steam will probably be the best one for me, because I've got a lot of campuses. Woohoo! I'm also getting now music, which is pretty cool. How many slots for music have I got these days? Not many, but that's okay. We can be buying this sort of stuff, like broadcast centers. Easily bought. Like, there is one there, for instance. So, down you go. It's Mikasa! Woohoo! Gives me a bunch of governor titles. Doesn't really do too much more for me, because, honestly, I mean, there's not much use for all of these governor titles at the moment. Oh, I say that. That's another vampire. Oh, my word. Okay, I take that back. I've named this one Rasputime for Blood. You see, the important thing is that I make myself laugh. Right, that's the most important thing here. I find it funny. Oh dear, where am I going to get my next castle? I need somewhere I can improve a load of land all around it. Let me have a look. Over here. It's got to be over here, I think. Right, let's do it. Made peace with Rome, which is really important, actually, because Rome have all of the great works I'm trying to buy up. They're also skint, which tends to help. There we go. These are the sort of deals, but crown of peace. Oh, wonderful. Wonderful stuff. I'm really starting to pick stuff up now, which is great. I'd have no relics. I really wish I'd met Candy a lot earlier in the game and I could have done something about that. Now, Coupe, do I make peace with Coupe? Because I'm just about to have a little bit of fun over here in his lands, and I don't know if it's worth it. Shall I? You know what, I'm going to... He's got pretty decent guards, so I'm going to, you know, make peace with him. That's fine. I think he's actually got quite a lot of money. I had seed the city. Yeah, I'm keeping that one. Hee hee. Just like good any good naval empire. He's actually got a lot of gold, so maybe I can get this from him, depending on who he wants to go to war with, if anyone. Anyone you want to go to war with? No, he's actually feeling peaceful. All right, well, we'll leave him alone. This is a good one, though. Portugal. Right, how much gold has Portugal got these days? 680 per turn. Let's see what we can do. Okay. Right, doesn't look like he wants to go to war at all at the moment. So, I mean, is that just because I was asking for too much? No, he really doesn't want to go to war at the moment, which is really disappointing. Oh, boo. Oh, now I've got peace with Venice. Now I get them on side. They're going to forgive my antics in their lands pretty quickly, I feel. But I know. This isn't why you watch my videos. You watch for railroads. Well, here we go. I think I've actually done it. I've connected up Stockholm to St. Petersburg. I've got down to my new Polish cities. I made a nice little loop around my conquered Turkish territories and down here. And here is the Siberian Express. I mean, it goes a little south. Admittedly, the Siberian Express should be up to the top here. But, I mean, I got it all the way from one coast to another. So, like, I'm pretty proud of that. I'm going to continue building because I've got 27 coal coming in per turn and nothing else to do with it. But, yeah, I'm pretty proud of that. I'm pretty proud. I'm just basically using all of his aid money. I don't need it. It's fine. I'm just buying art. I feel like... Yeah, that's not something that should be done with aid money, just buying art up, but never mind. Oh my word, what's this that Chompy sees? This city's rebelled! Oh no, China's not in the game anymore. Oh, what a shame. What a shame. Should we get Chompy? I think it's time to get Chompy, isn't it? Oh yeah. John Curtin's in the game. How did I not find him? That is remarkable. Friendship! Yay, Curtin's my friend already. Oh, that was easy. Right, a religious alliance with you, my friend. He'll give me some gold for that. Brilliant. Oh, I'm so pleased. What a nice meeting. How much gold have you got? This is the most important thing about my... It's not that I value my friends by how much gold they have, but I'm literally... That's the first thing I check. I can't go to war for Kemens. Oh, Cleopatra, though. Cleopatra coming at ya. No. Yep. Nobody's friends with her. Nope. Doesn't hurt to sort of wade in. Oh-ho. Fun. Oh, I think I may be at war with the Kemens all of a sudden. That could have been a mistake. Actually, to be fair, their units are pretty weak, so maybe it's not really a mistake, but I've probably built walls up here. Oh, this is a good excuse to get Lord Snacklington back into the action. Nice. Okay, yeah, you know what? This war with the Kemens may turn out to be quite entertaining. Oh no, Dido's gone to war with me. Oh, it's the ultimate betrayal. She was my ally for so long. Oh. Well, I guess it's probably a good thing. I can do some pillaging. Pillage. You know, with this, I think I've pretty much now settled the entirety of Russia. Pretty much. I mean, this is pretty good. The USSR. I think I've got all of the sort of where the Balkan states would be. Yes, I know I've got Sweden a little bit, but I'm calling it Finland. And Poland was partitioned and... Oh no, what are we doing? Okay, this is fine. Russia's expanded well. This is good. Now, we need to focus on the fun things. Come on, chemistry. How's our alliance coming, Ethiopia? Oh, two turns. Oh, and there we go. There's the boost actually in two turns as well. So that is perfect. Wonderful stuff. As soon as we get chemistry, we can go for rocketry. We can get some Russians in space before America, specifically. Liberate to China. Now end up keeping this one. Why not? Should be actually a pretty good amount of pillaging down here. A womp. Dub-a-dub-a-dum. Hooray! Cultural heritage. That's a nice pickup for me. I need more policy sluts. We need a better government, I think, is the way to describe this. Mobilization and then ideology, and then what's this? What's this? Oh yeah, that's right. Now that I'm at war, I just keep getting tons of era score every time somebody flips to my religion, which is like every other turn. Nice. I'm just doing this the long and slow way here. I'm in no rush to be killing the Kemans. I don't really need their land, but they declared war on me. Actually, no, that's a lie. I declared war on proxy by declaring war kind of on their allies. Could argue that's what happened, but it's fine. Now, these guys don't have very much money, which is good. They'll give me the art of war for, oh yeah, they're at 500 gold. Done. Still pillaging things. Actually, I can just steal a bit of science down here as well. Oh, Dido, you really shouldn't have left me all this stuff. There we go. Here's the alliance. Right, so we're going to find a load of stuff from Ethiopia here. So let's kill a Manjaro. Oh, African nations. Okay, including Mali. Mali, I'm really hoping I'm going to have a bunch of money. There is the Congo. And here is Mali. In fact, actually, yeah, the Congo, I'm hoping, should have great works as well. These guys normally collect them pretty well. Ah, they've got some landscapes. I mean, really, I'm a little disappointed by that. Congo did take friendship, though. That's exciting. Cool, so I've got an accidental alliance out of all of that. They really don't mind the fact that I've been killing people. Cool. Oh, yeah. Okay, so Mali wants to go to war with Gandhi. Okay, sure. Let's do it. Hooray! I mean, I do end up declaring war on, like, accidental people quite a lot here. But, you know, it's fine. Oh, America. I can make peace with America. Let's have a good old... Let's go back to old-fashioned Cold War. Hang on. 70 gold. Oh, why is America dealing badly with Russia? You know? Oh, funny that. There's chemistry. Research labs are amazing. Like, I'm very much looking forward to picking those up. Russia's getting cheeky into Kemen lands. Ooh, oh, oh. No one notices. No one notices this sort of brief excursion. I mean, I'd like to argue that there's a lot of Russians living in this land. I'm just protecting them. Finally, these debating apostles have made their way to America, and I'm just going to start sowing discord in here. What's it, Russia using agents in the Americas to sow a bit of craziness? I mean, I don't know what you're talking about. Military aid requests, who would ever join in with these things? I mean, who's possibly declaring war on, obviously? I don't know. Oh, actually, that is a military emergency. This may wreck my gold income, depending on who joins in on this one. Who has joined in? Coupe, Kemens, India. I think I was at war with all those people already, so that's actually fine. Finally got peace of America as well, which helps. It means that I'm not worried about my apostles dying. Scotland is still being a pain, to be honest. I can't even give them luxuries. I don't even want them. I keep forgetting my religion has crusade on it as well. It's very handy. It's brilliant. Okay, actually, for the first time, we've got Chompy and Lord Snacklington right next to each other, attacking at the same time. The gang is truly together, and I love it. Another kill. Ha ha ha. Oh, it's going to be intriguing watching my religion start to spread. Oh, look, actually, I've started to sow random religions around already now, which is cool. That's right, keep sending me missionaries. It's going to be good. Look at this preserve, by the way. They've put a preserve down, and they've improved every single tile or put a district around it. Like, why? Why would you do that? So I just bought... An anti-tank crew army somewhere else in my empire, and now Chompy's attacking with 139 strength. Wham! Okay, this has got to the point where this may be silly. Ideology! Hooray! Right, what are we going to do now? I think I've got some better options. So 5-year plan's got to come in now, instead of public works, which is a little bit annoying, but never mind. Levy on mass is doing pretty good. 60 gold per turn, it adds up. It adds up. Heritage tourism would give me a load more stuff. I mean, at the moment, I've got crazy science, culture, and tourism, but there's no point getting tourism because, as we have discussed before on this channel, the mod that lets you play with more than 20 players, it kind of glitches a little bit how tourism victories work, and it doesn't really do them properly, so there is a little bit of a problem with that, but we'll just sort of put up with it. Where is it? Class struggle. Oh, yes, two turns away. Time for a spaceport in St. Petersburg, haha. Even better, I now have a Cossack army that's going by itself into Egyptian lands and pillaging all their stuff. This thing is almost unkillable. It's brilliant. Continuing with the little religious kills. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Come on, I must be getting a couple of citizens now too over there. Oh! Okay, there you go. There's a citizen up there. There's one city that follows my religion. Brilliant stuff. See if we can get our religion voted up on that one. And I've learnt now, people want to vote campuses up. That's three times in a row that's come up on this Congress. I mean, people really like voting for you know, like the buildings. Now that I voted for that, it's going to clearly change into something else, you can just tell. No, campus! There we go! And Judaism. Oh, Judaism. Is that what I'm fighting up here? No, it's not. Eastern Orthodoxy is what I'm fighting. Okay, that's fine. I mean, I say fighting. I'm winning very easily here. Oh, there's another one! Class struggle. It's finally time. I hate communism, by the way. In this game, it's awful. I hate the production. I hate the science. It's just so much. Fascism's more fun. Democracy is more fun. But because we're playing as Russia, we've got to go for it. Russia chooses communism. Here we go. Right. Levy on mass. Logistics. We're going to get collectivization. I have all of my trade routes coming out of my capital right now, so my capital is about to go insane. Absolutely insane. Military research. Actually, if I build Renaissance walls, that gets better, so I probably should do that. Oh, no, ideology has just got rid of the lime, so... Okay, I can't do that. Raj, five-year plan, scripture. Yeah, that's all fine. And then, where's it gone? Republican legacy, get back in there. 41 amenities and 41 housing that card's giving me. That is nuts. And there we go. 640 science. Russia, we have finally gone communist. Sorry, Petter. We're not going to talk about what just happened to the royal family. I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure you guys are doing well. Oh dear. Sorry, I just need to denounce America because now we're communist. It's the right thing to do. What's this? Cold War? Cold War is the USSR? Oh, it's gotta happen. Oh, and computers. We're learning. We're getting there. Let's look at the oil. So one we've already got. Two, that can be improved pretty quickly. Let's just get a builder in there quickly. Lovely. Three. Oh, there's loads of oil in this desert. I knew settling in that area would be good. Four is under that district. Good. Five. Again in the desert over here. God, we're going to have so much stuff. That's under that one. That we've just seen. That's under that one. That's under that one. And there's some desert up in the north. Desert? There's some desert in the north. No oil in the north. Wonderful. So we're already getting 15 per turn. We're going to have a lot of oil. Oh, Russia. Russia. Having all this land. It's finally paying off for me. Finally paying off. The amount of times I play these games and get no strategic resources. Now is my time. Ho ho ho. In comes Mulan. And then this is an amphibious line inventory. It's like my Navy SEALs. Oh, wonderful stuff. And it's loyal already and it follows my religion. Oh, this game. Deity, hey? Very difficult. I love how Civ 6, just bless it, it cannot scale. It cannot scale to these large games and I would not have it any other way. Oh, Chompy! 140 attack! Ouch! That's brutal. That is brutal and we love to see it. Oh, they want peace, do they? They want peace. I kind of want... Oh, no, see, they're not going to make that deal under any circumstances. Well, in that case, I'm going to go and find your great works, my friend. And I'm going to steal them. I'm not even going for a culture victory. I just love building my culture up on 600 tourism so far. Already. Actually, scrap that. I am actually getting a tourist victory at the moment, which is cool. It's starting to go up. Who's the leader? Oh, it's the Kemens. The Kemens, the culture leaders. Well, you know. What I kind of wish in this game, what I really wish is that there was some sort of like puppeting system. Like if I could puppet these guys like you can in, say, Hearts of Iron, where I don't technically own the cities, but like they kind of like I control them anyway. That would be relatively entertaining. Anyway, another one bites the dust. 14 pop cities. Oh, the loyalty of these is going to be really tricky to hold on to, actually. They are properly tough. Oh, that's a military encampment. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Okay, well, here's an artillery army prayed into existence from nowhere. Yay! You gotta love it. You have to love it, especially because I'm just about to pick up a ton more oil. Like an absolute ton more oil. I love the idea of building a water park right in the Himalayas. Could you imagine just by Mount Everest? Come over. Come over to Hulan Lake. We have a massive water park here. You can go to Butlins whilst climbing Everest. Oh dear. I think that's probably quite a British reference, that Butlins. Did people get Butlins? Is that a thing? Is that well known enough? I've no idea. Oh no, it's Arthur. He's after my Cossack army. Quick! Run away! Run away! Just gonna treat myself to containment now. Now this is a fantastic policy card that lets you have two envoys every time you send one to a city-state, as long as you're a different government to the person that is suzerain, which is absolutely guaranteed because nobody is communist except me. Himiko's gone, and now she's back. That was a troublesome few seconds. Where do I need to go? Singapore? Is Singapore probably the easiest place for me to go right now? Let's do it. Let's actually bring her to the front line. That'll help just a bit. I need to move you like forward a little bit, and then I'm gonna get you into position, upgrade, lots of artillery armies now, which is wonderful. You're ready to go as well, and I think the only thing I was going to do was buy some support equipment in this city as well. Like, where is it? A drone. There's a drone. Wonderful stuff. And just to make it even better, here's another artillery army. You can heal in any other place. I should upgrade you quickly. And then again, artillery army. Perfect. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these things now. And a drone backing them up. Kaplunk. That is a pretty decent shot. What's that? Your city has almost full health? Well, here's Lord Snacklington, followed up by Chumpy McChumpington and Kablam. That city's now mine. Quick! Get the Inquisitor in. There we go. That religion's gone now. Oh, phew. Oh, wonder construction. Oh, that's actually quite good. Am I building wonders anywhere? Yeah, I've got some Basel's Cathedral, actually. That's a pretty decent one to boost.
One had a twisted
design. So I actually do have some relics, so I can get a bunch more faith from putting them in this city, which is wonderful. But this city's also got a bunch of tundra, which in theory could make my vampire castle better, although actually thinking about it, I think I've removed a bunch of the improvements around the castle, so I'm not entirely sure putting them back down would help at all. Oh, you see, look, that's quite... So what would it be? 6, 12, 18, 24... 31 production if I removed it and put it back. You know what, Smitty's kind of worth it now. I should replace the vampire castle. 23 production on that one. 5, 11, 18, 24. Yes, it is worth replacing them, even though I've kind of ruined the sites a little
bit.
Fair play. I'm pretty sure Russia built the Statue of Liberty in the Black Sea, didn't they? Yeah, sure. Oh, combined arms. Okay, once I've got that, I can go for nuclear fission and do the very Russian thing, which is stockpile nukes. Perfect. Right, now I'm just interfering in Mexico, this religion. Oh, yes, it's going to be very easy to flip. Oh, is that another city that's flipped to my religion? Oh, what a shame. What a shame, eh? I'm giving the impression that I'm giving peace to Egypt because, like, I'm being nice, but it's just because I've kind of pillaged absolutely everything I'm ever going to get from them. Oh, and actually, they're going to give me 7,000 gold to go to war with Pakachuti. He's giving me a lot of gold, but that's not going to last long. So, yep, I think this is going to be a match made in heaven. 20% production towards space race projects. Oh, yes, get Goddard in. I'm just spending money like crazy right now. Don't even care. And a very special shout out goes to Scott Stratton, Major King Kong, Matthew Wilkinson, Salty Tech, Midnight Oil, Truffadaskby, Paul Coffee, for all of your support on Patreon, as well as everybody else who likes, subscribes, joins Discord, and does all the silly things that keeps this channel going. Thank you so much.